What's going on, y'all? This is your boy Cal coming to you with another video. I know it's been a minute. I know it's been a few days since I come with another video, but we're going to talk about game just went final. Kansas wins the Big 12 81-70 over West Virginia. Although it wasn't double digit, West Virginia had like an 8. Yeah, I think they had a 7 or 8 point lead. I know they definitely had a 6 point lead with a. You know, still, of course, a lot of times when you're facing Kansas, they know they blew. In the last three games before this, they blown double digit leads, but this wasn't a double digit lead today. But still, another tough break for West Virginia against Kansas, man. I mean, it seems like every Big 12 team, when they face Kansas, man, it's just like something. My man Carrington Harrison from 610 Sports here in Kansas City he says Kansas got mind control. I mean, no matter what, it seems like Kansas can always find a way to get it done, especially when it involves the Big 12. And again, you've seen that this year with the 14th straight regular season title, and you see it with another Big 12 tournament title to add to their trophy case. I mean, of course, both of these teams were in the Big 12 tournament anyway, but, you know, of course, that tournament championship bragging rights. And, it was really a highly contested game. Of course, it always is with Kansas and West Virginia. You know, Bob Huggins, Bill Self, two of the best coaches in the nation. I mean, they were talking about it earlier on the broadcast, on the ESPN broadcast. The only thing that's really holding Bob Huggins back is the fact that he doesn't have a national title. I mean, of course, you know, Bill Self was inducted into the National Basketball Hall of Fame last summer. A tightly contested game. Again, West Virginia just went cold at the wrong times. You know, Dexter Miles, that dude was a beast at the start of the second half. He had 11 points in 5 minutes of the second half, and then he just disappeared. Javon Carter did his best. Kanate was blocking shots left and right. A real elite shot blocker. You know, of course, those were the big three for West Virginia. Miles had 25. Kanate had 18. And then Carter had 17. But again, the leadership of Devontae Graham in Kansas gets it done again. He had 18 points, 13 assists. He was really getting it done with his passing. Makai Luke, the other senior, he had 16, knocked down 4 threes in the game. But this tournament has been about two guys, Malik Newman and Silvio De Sousa. Hey, Malik Newman is the player of the tournament. He had they played 3 games. He had 25 the first game, 27, I think it was 27. 27 or 28. No, was it? Oh, I'm sorry, it was 23, I'm sorry. He had 25, 23. It was more than that. I'm sorry. I think it was 25, 27, and then he had 20 tonight. Dude has been unconscious this whole tournament. I forgot the real actual scores. Now let me look that up real quick. All right, I got my facts wrong. Newman had 30 in the first game against Oklahoma State, 22 in the game against K-State, and finally, of course, the 20 tonight against West Virginia. Now, of course, you know, Kansas caught a little break with K-State, Sid and Dean Wade, and then Barry Brown. I think it's poked in the eye by Devontae Graham first minute of the game, and he's out for the rest of the game. They caught a break there, but I mean, even with those guys in the lineup, you know, Kansas still was able to win two games against them in the regular season, and including beating the heck out of them at K-State Grambling Coliseum, which is a huge road test for anybody, but. Yeah, man. KU, again, Big 12 champs. More importantly, I believe that they might have secured the last number one seed. Well, I'm sorry, not the last number one seed, but they might have secured a number one seed. Of course, KU's the second big conference championship winner. I'm about to watch North Carolina and Virginia fight for the ACC title. I'm gonna turn and watch Providence and Villanova for the Big East championship. And still got the Pac-12 championship as well. And then the AAC, American Athletic Conference, Wichita State. Wichita State Conference. Wichita State got upset by Houston. I think Houston's the champion. I'm not sure. I don't know if they have theirs tomorrow. I know the SEC has it tomorrow. Tough. I'm a Mizzou fan. That was a tough loss to Georgia, man. And then Georgia loses to Kentucky yesterday, and they fired their head coach today. I mean, I hate that when you actually win a game, you're not supposed to win, and then the coach, you end up getting fired anyway. I guess that means you're supposed to get fired. They was going to fire you regardless, but that's tough. But yeah, really looking at the big tournaments. Of course, Michigan already won the Big Ten, which was played last week. We'll see what happens, man. We'll see what happens. I think the four number one seeds are already locked in now. Of course, Selection Sunday is tomorrow. Got Virginia. And I don't think it would change if Virginia loses tonight either. I really don't think that will change. I don't know if that will change them being a number one overall seed or not, but they'll definitely be a number one seed. Of course, the other ones, you got Villanova, Kansas, and Xavier, even though they lost yesterday in the Big East semifinal to Providence, who's playing Villanova right now. But I'm going to wrap this video up, man. Again, big-time effort by Kansas. They notch another Big 12 tournament championship to go with their go with all of their other tournament championships and all their regular season titles. That literally means nothing. But anyway, thank you guys for watching this video, and I might have a few more videos coming up tonight, if not tomorrow. I'm thinking about doing a live reaction to Selection Sunday. Well, of course, when the brackets are released, I'll say that. But I'm thinking about doing a live reaction to that. But we'll cross that bridge when we get there. Thank you guys for watching. I appreciate y'all. Let me know what you think about Kansas and the Big 12 and the rest of the NCAA tournament. I'd love to hear what you think. See y'all next video.